Saw you in October. I know a little bit of a frustrating defeat against a veteran there. I'm just curious kind of what lessons you took out of that matchup.
What's frustrating in that defeat? I don't feel like that was a defeat. That was a great fight, so I don't see the problem. Of course, I learned a lot after that fight. And, you know, facing a fighter like Carolina was great for me and for my experience in my career. So I'm happy that I had that fight. Of course, I didn't win it. And, yeah, I was disappointed after. But, come on, that was a great experience for me.
That's a very mature way to look at it. Do you feel that way immediately after the fight, or does it take some time for you to come to that realization?
I think I felt that way right after the fight. I always felt that way. I was never upset or mad that I lost that fight. Like, you know, this is the fight game. You win or you lose. But I love Carolina, and I'm happy that I had that fight. If I would have fought somebody that I didn't like it, probably I would have been, you know, really upset losing. But it is what it is, and this is the fight game, and I'm all in.
I love it. So you move forward. The UFC comes to you and they say, hey, how about a rematch with Molly McCann? What were your initial thoughts?
So, first of all, I have to admit that after I fought Carolina, I consider myself being done fighting, stepping down, and, you know, that's it. Sometimes we don't feel to do it, and that's okay. And I just wanted to find another way in life, and I was ready for that. But, you know, this rematch with Molly McCann, it's what took me back. So when UFC texted me and I saw that it's Molly McCann's name on that, I was like, hell yeah, I have to do it again. First of all, I have to do it for myself because I want to see where I stand right now. When I fought Molly, I was just a kid fighting at the wrong weight class. I just moved to Canada 2 months before that. So I was not ready at all for that fight. Now she's going to face a different fighter. I know she improved a lot. I know she's a different fighter too. But I really need to see my level right now.
Yeah. Are you worried at all about her making weight and, you know, how that would play out?
The only thing about the weight, I'm worried about my weight. That's my job, and I have to focus on that. I don't have time to focus on somebody's else's weight. You know, UFC has great rules about missing weight, and I'm not in charge of that. And to be honest, I don't really care.
Yeah. You said you think she's gotten better. Do you think she'll be a different fighter than when you fought the first time around? You said you will be. Will she be different?
She will definitely be a different fighter because I think at some point, Molly McCann was focused more on being a superstar than being a fighter. But her last fight, especially her last fight, made her realize how the fight game is and made her realize that she has to train and be a fighter before being a superstar. And I really think she's going to be a lot better than how she looked last 2, 3, 4 fights.
After this fight, do you think there'll be a question about whether you fight again? I mean, is that still a question in your mind about whether you want to keep doing this, or do you think you're back now?
For now, I don't know. I want to go Saturday night and do my best, let everything in that cage, and see how I feel. I'm not going to force myself to do something if I don't feel like doing it. For now, yeah, I like it. But let's see how it's going to end, and let's see how I'm going to feel. You know, don't be surprised if I'm going to win, and I'm still going to say, you know what, I don't feel like doing it. And just, I'm not going to do it if I don't feel to do it. I have so many options in life, and I can do so many things. I'm not going to just be stuck in something that if I don't enjoy 100%.
Yeah. You had an interesting quote on social media. I wanted to ask you what it was. It was, pay close attention to those that don't clap when you win. That doesn't seem like a general statement. That seems like a very specific, directed statement. Can you explain what that relates to?
It doesn't direct to someone specifically, but, you know, if the shoe fits, wear it, Cinderella.
Nice. Last thing for me, as you said, entertaining fight last time. Are you expecting kind of an entertaining back-and-forth scrap? Is this a fight you can dominate? What do you think we see?
Hell yeah, this fight is going to be a war. Because, it's Molly McCann and it's me. We both like to stand in the middle of the cage and bang. We don't like to go on the ground, all that ground game. Yeah, of course, she improved that a lot. I improved that a lot, too. But we are going to use just to stand up. Let's be honest.
Diana, to your right, can you expand a little bit on what you meant when you said Molly was more focused on being a superstar? Like, what did you see her do that made you think that?
I think she enjoyed a little bit the media days, the pictures, the attention that she had, you know, you know, Molly and Patty, the Baddies, all that story. I really feel like now she's not that much on a media. She's not that much online. She's more time in a gym. She spends more time in a gym training and focusing on herself as a fighter, not as a superstar.
Is this sport one that humbles you like occasionally, and that you have to accept, you know, you feel you're on top and then all of a sudden you feel you're not below after one other fight?
Oh my God, this sport, trust me, it takes you on a top and puts you on the bottom the next day. So of course there are moments that humble all of us. I don't know, maybe at some point I will be the same. I will think I'm a superstar. I will think I'm, I don't know, some big fighter, and I will realize, I will take a bit and then realize that it's not like that.
Diana, were you bummed that you didn't get to fight in Toronto 2 weeks ago?
I was there.
Did you want to fight on Toronto?
No, I didn't want to fight. I just said I was done. Like I was not, I didn't even think. Yeah, I was thinking about that fight card, but before I fought Carolina. And then after I fought Carolina, I was like, I know UFC is going to come to Toronto, but I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to watch it. No, I didn't even think about that. And I'm not upset that I was not on that card. I was on the crowd. I was watching. I was cheering for the Canadians. I was enjoying the fights. And here I am now.
Do you still feel like you have the best hair in the UFC?
Can you say no? Can you deny that? Let's be honest. I feel like my hair is getting better and better every training camp, especially, you know, cutting weight, eating healthy. My hair is growing.
All right. You win.
Thank you.